Why do you think people struggle in walking in their purpose, or what is preventing them from walking in their purpose? Could you give us your insight about it?
So that's a very important aspect that you asked me about in the book. That's one of the sections that I spoke, because I believe it's one thing to discover your purpose and it's another thing to walk in your purpose. And people struggle a lot when it comes to walking in their purpose, because discovering your purpose is just, you know, one small part of it. But walking in it is another level. And I believe that you'll face a lot of challenges, and it's not going to be an easy thing when you say yes to the call and plan on will of God. The enemy is not going to give you a red carpet and say, come on, let's go and fulfill your purpose, because you're going to see a lot of opposition, you're going to face some challenges, you're going to go through some betrayals, you're going to go through a lot of struggles that you didn't expect. And so one of the reasons I specifically set apart a section of the book just to encourage people in this regard is because I believe it is something that can cause you to even give up. Or in some cases, it can even ask, make you end your life or anything of that sort. So I believe that you can face a lot of hindrances to walking in your purpose. I'll just share one by one. One of them could be discouragement, because it's not going to be like, okay, wow, I have 2,000 friends on Facebook. So, you know, the minute I start, all of them are going to support me. No, if you see two people who are going to support you in liking all your posts, that's going to be a great deal. So you will have a lot of expectations, thinking your friends will be there for you, your family will be there for you. But you will actually go through a season where you realize when you say yes to the call of God, there will be times you'll be tested all alone. Like Abraham was tested all alone with his promise, Isaac, on the top of the mountain. Nobody else was with him at that juncture. So the time you would go through those testing moments, you will be facing it alone. And as much as I've seen in my own ministry when I started it, you know, which just turned eight about a week ago, what happened was, I mean, as much as I've spoken to crowds of thousands of people, there were times I spoke to literally nobody. In the sense, I planned everything, set everything, and spent a lot of money, and did all the advertising and all of that. And nobody, I mean nobody, showed up. So I have those photographs because I ministered to empty chairs, believing that one day God's going to help me minister to a multitude or whatever. But the point here is, in that, if you go through such seasons, you may want to, you'll feel discouraged and you want to give up. So that's one of the hurdles that a lot of people face. The second one is opposition. Opposition from, you know, enemies is one thing, but opposition from your near and the dear ones is going to really rip apart your heart. You'll experience, you know, people whom you thought will trust, will depend on you, will support you, will be the ones who are actually deserting you, questioning your vision. And then, like Jesus himself said, you know, a prophet is not accepted in his own hometown. And we see that many times. And people tend to think, you know, am I doing something wrong? Am I going in the wrong track? Why is it my own family is not supporting me? So you go through a season of question. You'll go through a season where, it's one thing if you just go on the road and somebody makes fun of you or, mocks at you or doesn't accept you or, you know, treats you unfairly, it's one thing. But when your own family, the ones you live with, are not supportive, it gets really hard. So these are some reasons, and also it involves a lot of risks. Many people don't want to do that. I mean, people say, be safe here. You know, let's not take the extra step of stepping out of the comfort zones. But I believe that, you know, you cannot walk into the fullness of your God-given destiny without taking a step of faith into what he has called you for. When God called Abraham, he had to leave his comfort. He had to leave his family and go to the place God called him. So many people find it difficult to do all of that. And I believe everybody has issues. I do believe everybody has commitments, financial commitments, family commitments. But then when it comes to the call of God, you know, Jesus said, you know, whom do you love more? You love me or you love your family, your friends and everybody. So you have to make that decision, which many people unfortunately don't, because they try to use all the cards in the table to say, oh, come on, you know, I am the one who birthed you, so you have to do what I say. I'm the one who paid your fees, so you have to do the course I say. But the truth to be told is, you know, God is the one who called and created everyone. So we have to say yes to him. But unfortunately, many people give way to, oh, okay, I have to have peace in my family, I have to have this, I have to have that, and then end up forfeiting their purpose. So I think these are a couple of points that I believe are the reasons why many people are, you know, and one more thing is, you know, people are looking at the current scenario, just for example. You know, people often tell, you know, it's hard to find a job, so don't quit your job, you know, stuff. But if God calls you to do something, I'm not asking everybody to quit, okay? I'm just saying in specific, if God calls, you know, you have to do it. You know, I just spoke about this and I'll close with this. In Mark chapter 4, you know, there's a huge crowd and the disciples and Jesus are there. And then Jesus says, come on, let's go to the other side of the lake. And then they go to the other side of the lake and they're met by one man. So in a natural sense, it looks like he was unsuccessful. It's like quitting a job which gives you 20,000 to go to a job which gives you 5,000. It makes no sense. But if God says to do it, would you do it? So that's this point that I want every one of us to go to, where we say yes to the plan, the will and purpose of God over the reality of the circumstance.
We hope you were blessed by this special program by the John Gifter International Ministries, and we are looking forward to hear from you. We invite you to stay connected with us through all our services, events, YouTube and other social media forums for regular inspirations, teachings and further updates. You can also know more about our ministry by logging on to www.johngifter.com. If you have been blessed by this program and would like us to continue to bless more people, we encourage you to partner with us financially. If you are led to sow into the John Gifter International Ministries, you can now transfer your funds through net banking or Google Pay. Thank you once again for staying tuned. God bless you.